What's the vibe like around here, Julius?
Fun, energetic. Guys are hungry. Yeah.
How's your health?
My health? What you think?
That's
what I look like, man. I look good. Other than me, on me splitting my hand open, I'm good.
Can you talk about your off-season workout plan and what you want to
do? Y'all heard that? Call me D'Angelo.
My bad.
I ain't even light skinned, man.
Randle.
What's up?
Now, can you talk about your off-season workout plan, what you worked on?
Yeah, I just worked on everything. Shooting, finishes around the rim. And just, studied, worked on playing the right way, get in the best shape, and pretty much it. Yeah, now you good. I'm messing with you.
What's the range on your shots right now? What would you say?
I can shoot.
You feel you can go up to 3.9?
I guess you go see.
Julius, Luke talked a lot about changing some culture.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about that, what you've seen with him coming in this summer. And
yeah.
Is it needed?
Yeah. Guys are playing for each other, playing hard, unselfish, just making the game simple and just playing for each other. Putting the other guy before yourself. So
there's a lot of people that get to know this year, including your new head coach.
We've been up here every day this summer, and he's already instilled a great vibe, a great energy through our team, and we're excited.
Did you have any time to work with Draymond Green?
Yeah, man. I did a little bit at the USA, but not as much. He had the USA stuff, and it was a long summer for him, going into the playoffs. But he's a phone call away. So
you feel like that could be the role, a similar role, the one that he plays there, is kind of like a.
Yeah, man. I mean, they play a fun way. How they play is fun, very carefree and unselfish, and. That's how we want to play. We want to make the game easier on ourselves, but play hard and play for one another.
I think you'd be a small ball center and passes and all the.
That's what coach will decide. I mean, I feel like I can do anything on the court that he puts me up there to do. So.
You believe in that?
Absolutely, yeah. Why not?
Work you've done this summer. What's your expectation on how that translates
into the season? I put in the work, and I just let what I did this summer as far as how I work. Do what it does for itself. I don't have any expectations. I'm not gonna put pressure of expectations. I don't even believe in that, but I'm not gonna put expectations on numbers and all that. What I want to do, I just want to win. I want to get better every day, and I feel like that's our vibe right now.
What'd you get out of that?
Oh man, you just Coach Pop is big on playing for your teammate, being over yourself. And then you also get to play against pros every day, all-stars, star players, and you get to see how they work every day, and you get to take that and, put a little bit of that into your game.
It's a really international roster this time around. How do you think that helps, and how is it different?
It's going to help. We got guys, international, different teams, whatever. Everybody does, their own thing. Everybody does stuff a little bit different. But I like our group of guys. I like our attitude going into camp. And it should be fun.
There's a lot of talk about putting your teammates over yourself. Mm-hmm. Is that something that was maybe missing that is going to be kind of the key this year?
Yeah, I think last year we played a little bit too much for ourselves, whether we were trying to get stats or whatever it may be. And it just doesn't work. Open man gets a shot. We're going to be on one accord on the defensive end, communicating. We're going to be in the best shape of our lives. We're going to get up and down. And that's what it's about. Everything else takes care of itself.
You didn't want to put a number on it, but what is the success for this group?
Playing hard as we can every day. Competing. Everybody coming in every day with a positive attitude to get better. And to get better every game. We got to show that we are getting better. So, not to anybody else, but to ourselves.
Is there a sense of the start of you guys building something new here?
Absolutely. The energy, the vibe is different. Just everybody is just enjoying each other, the game is starting to become fun again. You win 15 games in every, or what is it, 17 games we won last year, and everything feels like press, you know, a struggle, it doesn't make the game fun. So we're just trying to get back to the game being fun and playing hard for one another. Man, the Mamba. I was actually with him the other day. Just how intelligent he is. You know, his very detailed and his understanding of the game. You know, he just doesn't work hard out here on the court. It's easy to come out here every day and work hard on the court or whatever it may be. But, you know, he puts a lot of work into off the court, you know, looking at guys' tendencies, doing the homework and stuff like that. And obviously going to miss his competitive nature. So,
the possibility of you and Larry playing more together this year?
It's going to be fun. You know, like I said, the small ball stuff, but it's putting an athletic group out there on the court, guys who can get up and down, guard multiple positions, and, you know, especially today's NBA, that's kind of hard to guard, so it should be fun.
What have you seen from him? I mean, he's been kind of doing mid-range work a lot this season.
He looks good. You know, Larry's always playing the right way, playing hard, you know, in the right place at the right time, and, you know, obviously everybody's working hard. Everybody's putting in work. He's putting in work. So it should be fun.
Yeah.
Huh? No, I mean, I just hit him up, just a workout. I can't give out secrets, man. Now y'all asking too much now.
What's your take on Kaepernick and his protest?
Yeah, I think something will happen, and you know, Commissioner Silver and you know the Players Association doing a great job of getting behind the players. Obviously, guys have concerns, and you know, guys want to have a voice, you know, in the situation, and they're doing a great job of getting behind us and finding the right meaningful way to make an impact on the community.
Kaepernick's message needs to be said.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to get too in detail on you know that situation, but. I think definitely, you know, there's a way for us all to get together and make a meaningful impact on what's going on because, you know, guys need to say something. Something needs to be said.
Julius, kind of on the flip side of what you were saying about Kobe, Jordan was describing certain belief maybe that you know, that time has come and now it's your guys' opportunity to kind of, you know, take the torch.
Yeah.
What's your sentiment on that? Is that
true
for you as well?
Yeah, I mean, you know, obviously Kobe, you know, instilled a great sense of, you know, work ethic, brought 5 championships to this organization. So, you know, he did a great job and, you know, my growing up as a kid, you know, being able to watch him and stuff like that has been great for me. So, you know, he's gone and, you know, it's our time now, but we got to do it together.
When did it stop, or has it stopped being weird that when you walk in here, you're just definitely not going to see him?
No, it's not weird. I mean, life moves on, life goes on. So just because Kobe's retired, you know, the Lakers organization is not going to stop. So we got to go on and got to get better.
Did you expect those kind of screams, you know, from that last game?
Yeah, hopefully they let me get away with that. I think they let me get away with a couple because it was the last game, but we'll see.
Hey, Julius, how do you and the rest of the young core kind of build that leadership back, just knowing the personalities you guys have, different leaders, or different, you know, talents?
I think we're going to be very vocal. You know, guys like me, D'Angelo, JC, whoever it may be. I think we're going to be very vocal and hold each other accountable. Can't keep doing the same things and expect something to change. So we're going to be vocal, hold guys accountable, and hold guys accountable for playing the right way. Yeah, absolutely, especially from a leadership role and being vocal in that sense. Definitely more responsibility, but nothing can't handle.